Hello, namaste, and welcome to Yoga Nature Sheffield. Thank you for joining us today. So in today's class, we're focusing on sun and fire practices. So we're looking at Surya Namaskar, and we're taking a real comprehensive look at it. And we're breaking it down into the individual postures. And then this is a series of classes that we're running. So today you're receiving the first of the five. And then by the end of the week, we're hoping to give less guidance. So today in this session, we're breaking down the postures and making it very accessible to the majority of people. And we're also looking at fire practices. So what you will need for the class is a mat and some props to help you sit and a blanket for the relaxation. So if you go and get those, that would be great. You can pause the video here so you can go and get everything. And then the other thing, once you've gotten all your equipment, is you really need to be aware of your health. And can you have a look at the health disclaimer that we've also included in the notes down below underneath this video? That would be really great. And obviously you shouldn't be doing this video if you have any health concerns or if you're unsure. And if you think you can do the video and you experience any pain or discomfort or shortness of breath, then you stop the practice and you shouldn't do any of it and get in touch with us so we can guide you a little bit further. So from this point on, we're going to begin to explore the sun and fire practices. So when you're ready to, if you bring yourself to a comfortable seated position, please. So we always begin our classes with a settling practice. So you want to place, well, I like to kneel, and the reason I kneel is because I have a nerve problem with my left lower leg, and if I sit too low, it aggravates the nerve issue. So I sit quite high in a kneeling position, but if you're really comfortable being cross-legged, or you can even use a chair, you can even have your legs stretched out in front, then please go for one of those options. Once you're in the seated posture of your choice, we're going to begin by exploring a hand gesture, and the hand gesture is known as the Gyan Mudra. And Gyan translates as wisdom or knowledge. And we want to work with the Gyan Mudra because it links in quite well with the sun practices, because it begins to activate a center here that we have in the third high. When we activate this center, it begins to awaken consciousness. It's said to remove our ignorance and darkness, and the light begins to illuminate within, and we become awakened beings. And in this period that we're currently going through, it's really quite important to have like a lot of light and to begin to become awakened and empowered individuals. So the Gyan Mudra is very simple. The thumb and index fingers touch, or if you prefer, the index fingers can connect with the base or the roots of the thumbs. The three fingers are outstretched. And now you have a choice. You can either place the hands on the knees. If you're cross-legged, that's usually where they go. Or if you're in any other position, you place them on the thighs. You lengthen through the spine and you relax through the shoulders. Place the head on top of the spine. And then just allow the body to become soft. And check that there's a little gap between the teeth and the lips are lightly touching. If you feel comfortable closing your eyes, if you don't feel comfortable closing your eyes, then softly gaze towards the camera or towards a point on the floor in front of you. And then you begin to make the connection to the breath. You feel the cool air entering your body and the warmer air leaving your body. The cool air entering your body and the warmer air leaving your body. Cool air entering and the warmer air leaving your body. Continue in this way to gently practice breath awareness. Allow every breath to gently allow you to settle into your body, to arrive into the moment. I am breathing in the present moment, and I am breathing out the present moment. And in a moment, I'm going to sing a mantra. It's known as the Savitri Mantra. And no need to open your eyes if your eyes are closed. The Savitri Mantra will be in the description box below. We'll also include that in the box below. The Savitri Mantra is a mantra that's been sung for between 3,000 to 4,000 years. So it's been continuously being practiced since millennia, 3,000 to 4,000 years. And because it's been practiced for so many thousands of years, it's gathered a lot of power. So as you listen to the mantra, you want to not only listen with your ears, but see if you can listen with the whole of your body. And see if you can feel the mantra igniting all of your atoms within your body. The Savitri mantra is a mantra that's honoring the sun and honoring the light within us. So before I chant the mantra, I'd like to invite you to chant three Oms with me. Breathing in deeply now. Resting with your eyes closed and listening to the vibration of the Savitri Gayatri Mantra.
Om Bhurvasvaha Tat Savitri Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Naha Prachodayat. Om Bhurvasvaha Tat Savitri Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Naha Prachodayat. Om Bhurvasvaha Tat Savitri Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Naha Prachodayat.
Now when you next breathe out, ground your awareness through the connection your sit bones or your shin bones make to the earth. Feel that deep rooted connection that you have with the earth, feel grounded and supported, nourished in your practice today. Gently opening your eyes. So we're going to begin with seated practice. And as the days progress, I want us to begin to master a practice known as Agni Sakriya. And Agni Sakriya is the essence of fire. And it's a great one for activating the energy center that resides within the belly, known as Manipura Chakra. Manipura Chakra translates as the jeweled city. So we're going to work with that. And there are different stages to it. So we're going to begin to explore the stages seated. And then the aim is by the fifth day, we hopefully can do Agni Sakriya with minimum instructions. So we're going to begin with the pelvic floor area. So in Agni Sakriya, we create a bandha, which is known as Mula Bandha. Mula translates as root and bandha translates as seal. So we're going to begin by taking our awareness from the pubic bone to the tailbone. So all of the pelvic floor area. And then on the inhale, you want to squeeze all of that area. And you might feel that your seat lifts a little. And then on the exhale, you release all of that area. So breathing in, you contract all of the muscles from the pubic bone to the tailbone. And then on the exhale, you soften here. And we'll do that three more times. Inhaling, contracting. Exhaling, releasing. Inhaling, contracting. Exhaling, releasing. Inhale, contract. And exhale, release. So having contracted all of the pelvic floor area, we now want to isolate different parts of the pelvic floor. So the first mudra is a gesture. It's known as the Ashwini mudra. And this is where we contract and release the anal sphincter. Obviously, all the contractions that we're doing through the pelvic floor area are really good for toning and keeping the various parts of the pelvic floor really nice and healthy and strong. So you become aware of the anal sphincter And we begin to practice Ashwini Mudra by on the inhale gently contracting that area and on the exhale releasing. Breathing in a small contraction here and then on the exhale release. Inhaling another small contraction and exhale release. Continuing this way. And you may find that when you're practicing it for the first time that you're contracting more muscles than what's required, but that's okay. All you need to do is you just keep practicing, and with time you can enable the practice to become subtler. Contract one more time and release. So now we're becoming aware of the urethra area. So we're taking our awareness to the front of the pelvic floor, to just behind the pubic bone. And you want to become aware of the urethra. And in a moment we're going to contract and release the urethra. So when you have the feeling that you need to pass urine, and to stop the urine from passing, you gently squeeze the urethra. And that's what we're trying to mimic here. So when you're eight on the inhale, a gentle contraction here. And then on the exhale, releasing. Breathing in another gentle contraction. And breathing out, releasing. So when women practice this, the mudra, the gesture is called Sahajoli Mudra. And when the gentleman practice it, is known as Rajoli Mudra. Inhaling a gentle contraction of the urethra and then exhaling, gently releasing, breathing in a very gentle contraction and breathing out, releasing. Two more times. And then bring the practice to the close. Now, between the anal sphincter and the urethra, between Ashwini Mudra, Sahajoli or Varjoli Mudra, there is the root seal, which is known as Mula Bandha. So in gentlemen, it's just behind the testicles, and in ladies, it's in the opening of the cervix. So you're taking your awareness to this area of the pelvic floor, and then on the inhale, you gently contract. And when it's contracted, it's known as Mula Bandha. You've created the root seal. And then on the exhale, you gently soften this area. Breathing in, gently contracting this area. And breathing out, gently softening. Inhaling, gently contracting the area. And exhaling, gently softening. And again, when you're practicing Mula Bandha, you may find that you're using more muscles that are required. But again, it's a very subtle practice. The more you practice it, the more you'll be able to refine it and also connect to the subtleties of the practice. So it's okay if you're contracting more muscles, that's absolutely fine. But just be aware you want to start isolating it with time once you become more familiar with it. And have one more contraction here and then releasing. And then just relax the whole of the pelvic floor, relax the whole of the body. So you're guiding your awareness now to the belly. And for Agnisar Kriya, it's contraindicated to do the type of breathing where we pump the stomach. So it's contraindicated if you're pregnant, if you're on the first 3 days of your period, if you have peptic ulcers, if you've had any operations in the last 3 to 5 years, if you've had a baby and the abdominal walls haven't knitted together, or maybe you just don't like doing it, then that's okay. So we're going to begin off with an alternative. So the alternative is like on the inhale, you expand the belly, and then on the exhale, you draw the belly towards the spine. Breathing in, expanding the belly, and breathing out, draw the belly towards the spine. Inhaling, expanding, and exhaling, drawing the belly towards the spine. And then complete one more round here. And then bring the practice to a close. And the practice also has a throat seal. And the throat seal is known as Jalandhara Bandha. So when you engage Mula Bandha and Jalandhara Bandha, you begin to build pressure within the trunk of the body. And you begin to build the pressure of prana. And when you release those bandhas, that energy flows to the extremities of the body. And it's meant to give the body a real big boost, a big oomph, if you like. So to practice Jalandhara Bandha, to create the throat seal, you really need to have a real stable base of support. If your knees are off the floor, you might want to place blankets underneath the knees. And then what we do is we drop the chin and then we raise the head up. And you almost feel, you do feel a pressure here, as if someone's placed their hand here. It's almost a feeling of constriction. So some people don't like this, and if you don't like it, you can just do a gentle one. You just drop down and just raise the shoulders up just a tiny bit. But traditionally is the chin comes down, the shoulders lift. And your arms, the elbows have to be straight. So you've created two pillars or two columns with your arms, nice and strong. And then when you're ready to, you drop the shoulders and you raise the head back up. So the chin comes down, shoulders come up, you lean forward a little bit, you're pushing your hands into your legs, and you hold the bandha. And then when you're ready to, you drop the shoulders and you raise the head up. So we'll do that one more time. You take the chin towards the chest. You raise the shoulders up. The weight comes forward a little. You push your hands into your legs. The arms become straight. And you hold here. And then you drop the shoulders and you place the head back on top of the spine. So now we're going to move into the exploration of Surya Namaskar. So we're going to have a very much of a beginner's mind. So if you're watching this video and you're really familiar with Surya Namaskar, then, you know, just take yourself back to when you were first learning it. Because even though we've been practicing it for many years, many of us get into bad habits. So the Surya Namaskar that we're exploring today is taken from the Satchananda Yoga School. And the Satchananda Yoga School have developed this Surya Namaskar that has 12 postures in it, and each of the postures, 12 postures, represent the 12 calendar months, and they also represent a mood or a rasa, a taste, a flavor. So from when the moment the sun begins its journey in the morning to the moment it finishes its journey, it goes through various stages through the day, and it has a particular quality that is associated with it. So each of the positions also represents one of the moods that the sun is exploring or experiencing during its journey. So when you're ready to, you're going to bring yourself to a standing position. So position one is known as the mountain pose or prayer position, pramasana, and you want to begin with your feet hip width apart. The easiest way to measure hip width is you place the heel of one foot into the instep, come up onto the ball of the foot, pivot on the ball and align the toe. Then you bring the hands into prayer, thumbs lightly pressed into the sternum, shoulders are relaxed, and you begin to make the connection to the breath. You begin to feel how the weight is distributed across the soles of your feet. You're checking that your feet are, the weight is not too far forward onto the toes, nor is it too far back onto the heels. So you're checking that the weight is evenly distributed across the soles of your feet. And then you want to become aware of your ankles. Feel how the knees are on top of the ankles, and that the knees are a little soft. They're not locked back, nor are they bent too much. Then become aware of the hips, how their hips are on top of the knees and the ankles. Pelvic basin is in neutral. Then you begin to grow tall and you relax the shoulders, placing the head on top of the spine. Tuck the chin down and slightly back. If you take your awareness to the top of your head, to the crown, and then from the crown, travel back. So top towards the back of the head. And if you visualize, you have a little thread here that's linked to a helium balloon, and you feel yourself gently being pulled up towards the sky. The helium balloon is making you light. And to help this process, we can use the breath. So on the inhale, as the breath flows through the feet up to the crown of the head, feel as if you're creating space through your body. And then on the exhale, as the breath travels back down, feel yourself grounding and rooting into the earth. Breathing in, breath and awareness flowing up. And breathing out, breath and awareness flowing down. Nice. So that was position one. Position two is, on the inhale, you allow the hands to travel up, brushing the third eye. You open up the arms and you introduce a very gentle back bend. This is position two. And you hold. And then on the exhale for position three, we bend the knees and we softly fold into a forward bend. Then position four, we become aware of the right leg, and on the inhale we step the right leg back. We place the knee onto the floor. And just note that the toes of the right foot are tucked under, the left knee overshoots the ankle, fingertips push into the earth, lengthen through the spine, and you're looking up towards Brahmadya, the third eye. And then when you're ready to breathe out, you step the right foot forward. And then we're going to repeat to the left. On the inhale, you step the left leg back, making your way into runner pose. Keep the toes on the floor. Allow the right knee to overshoot the ankle. Push the fingertips into the floor, lengthen through the spine, and gaze up at Brahmadya. Nice. And then when you're ready to breathe out, bring yourself to a comfortable seated position of your choice. From runner, the next pose that we explore is called Down Facing Dog. So we're going to do Down Facing Dog from Cat to begin with, and then I'll show you how you do it from Runner Pose. So the reason that we're doing it from Cat first is so that you get an idea of where your hands and feet should be placed when you go into Down Facing Dog. So you make, or you're just watching actually, sorry about that. So I'm making my way into Cat. So my knees are beneath my hips and my hands are beneath my shoulders. I've opened up the fingers and thumbs. And then I'm tucking the toes under and I'm taking my bottom to the heels. And then I'm going to lift my knees off the floor, but first I need to activate my arms. So I push my hands into the mat, activating the arms, activating the muscles around the shoulder blades. And then I raise the knees up off the floor. And I want to keep the belly close to the thighs as I lift the tail up. So do you see how my heels are high? Heels are high, belly to thighs, and then I drop my head down. I have long hamstrings so I can get my heels to the floor with ease. If you have tight hamstrings, stay high on your toes, bend the knees and take your belly to your thighs. And you hold Down Facing Dog. And then on the exhale, we come back down, knees to the floor. And you note that my knees and feet and hands haven't moved at all. So now if you join me, if you bring yourself to all fours, and if you check that your hands are beneath your shoulders, your knees are beneath your hips, there's a gap between your knees, your heels are aligned with your knees. Open up your fingers and thumbs so you've created your doggy paws. Tuck your toes under. Take your bottom to your heels. Activate the arms by pushing the arms into the mat. And then lift the knees off the floor. Keep the belly to the thighs as you take the tail high. Belly to thighs, belly to thighs. Drop the head and hold. If you've got the long hamstrings, ease the heels to the floor, but there's a little bend in the knees. Or if you've got the tight hamstrings, keep the feet high, the heels high, and you come into dog. And then notice where your hands and where your feet are. So that when you go into dog from runner pose, you're placing your feet and your hands in approximately the same position. Then when you're ready to, you take your knees to the floor and you come back into cat. Fantastic. So if you have a little seat and a drink of water, and then I'm just going to show you how you get into dog from runner pose. So I come back to runner and I'm going to bring my left leg forward. And the left knee overshoots the ankles and the toes of the right foot are under. Lengthen through the spine and I'm looking up. And then from this position, I'm going to raise the right knee and I'm going to step the left foot back. And then I'm trying to find the shape that I was in when I went from cat into dog. And then when it feels right, I hang out here. And then I come back down into cat. And then we'll do it the other way. So if you're ready to, if you join me, so if you come to a high kneeling position and you step your left foot forward, place your fingertips on the floor, tuck the toes of your right foot under. Fingertips so you lengthen through the spine and you look up. And then when you're ready to, we're going to step back into down facing dog. And then just find, place your feet in the position that they were when you went into dog from cat. Have a little play. See if your body feels like it's finding the shape you explored earlier. And then when you've completed, let's come back down onto the knees. And let's do the other side. Now we're ready to step the right leg forward. Toes of the left foot are tucked under, lengthen through the spine and look up. And now we're ready to raise the left knee under and we step back to dog. And again, you're finding the shape. So you want to find, place your hands and your feet in about the alignment you had when you went into cat. And you hold here. And then when you're ready to, knees to the floor. And relax and release. So probably the trickiest part in the sequence is having to step the foot forward from down facing dog. So I'll just demonstrate that. So what happens is we go, oh no, I tell a lie, I need to back up a little bit. So from down facing dog, we end up going rainbow cat and then extended cat. So I'll just demonstrate that. So what happens is with the left leg forward, so I'm in runner and I'm looking up, I step back to down facing dog. And then from down facing dog, I place my knees onto the floor. I hug the belly in and I'm dropping the head. So this is what I call rainbow cat. And then on the inhale, I drop the belly and I come into extended cat. So spinal extension. So when you're ready to, if you come on to a high kneeling position and if you step the left leg forward, bend the left knee, fingertips are on the floor, toes of the right foot are tucked under, lengthen through the spine and look up. And then when you're ready to, raise the right knee, step forward with the back left leg into down dog. And then when you're ready to, you place your knees to the floor, you're hugging the belly in, you make your way into rainbow cat. And then on the inhale, you make your way to extended cat. So this is a modified version. We're not doing the traditional version just yet. When you're ready to, you come up to a high kneeling position. And you bring the right foot forward now. The right knee overshoots the ankle. The toes of the left foot are tucked under. Lengthen through the spine, look up. And then we go into down dog. So the left knee comes up. We step back with the right leg into down dog. And then from here we go rainbow cat. Knees to the floor, hug the belly in. Chin towards the chest, rainbow cat. And then into extended cat. Nice. How are you doing? Does that feel all right? I hope it does. So the tricky bit that I started to talk about a little bit too early is from, so after happy cat, we go back into down dog and we need to step the right leg forward again. So this is tricky for a lot of people, including myself. And it can be for a variety of reasons that is tricky. It could be just the shape of our bodies, or it could be our muscles, our legs are not stretched out as we'd like them to be, or it could be for another reason. So from happy cat, just watch me again. So from happy cat, from spinal extension. So when I teach yoga to kids, I call this happy cat because it makes your spine smile. So you're in spinal extension. And then from here, the toes would have been tucked under. So the toes are tucked under. Then we make our way into dog. So traditionally, even when I was thinner, I've never been able to do this. So what they ask you to do is to step the right foot forward between the hands. I don't know why I've never been able to do it, but I can't do it and I find it very difficult. So what I've done is I developed a little cheat. So if I go back to down dog, if you can step it forward between the hands, that's fantastic. But if you're like me, you might develop a little cheat where you take the right leg out to the side and then you place the right hand on the outside of the right leg. Then you place the left knee on the floor and you look up. So that's one option that's available to you, right? And then the other option, which is a little bit more graceful, is you're in dog, you place the knees on the floor, unhook the feet, come up to high kneeling, you step the right foot forward, and you make your way back into runner. So now let's do that together. So when you're ready to, if you come into cat, and if you go tuck your toes under and make your way into spinal extension, when you're ready to, you come up into down facing dog. Then you become aware of the, let's do the graceful one. So let's do knees to the floor first, unhook the feet, come up to a high kneeling position, step the right foot forward, toes of the left foot are tucked under, lengthen through the spine and look up. And when you're ready to, making your way back into cat. So spine is extended, toes are tucked under, bottom to the heels, lift the knees up, make your way into dog. And then those of you who can step the foot forward between the hands with ease, that's the right foot, please do so. Alternatively, step the right foot forward, however is comfortable for you. And then place the left knee onto the floor, lengthen through the spine. And look up. Fantastic. So let's do the left side. So you're making your way back into cat. Toes are tucked under. Bottom to the heels. Lift the knees up. Make your way to down dog. And then place the knees onto the floor. Step the left foot forward into runner. Toes of the right foot are tucked under. Then releasing. Making your way back into cat, toes are tucked under, spinal extension, bottom to the heels, knees up, dog, down facing dog. And you become aware of the left leg. And again, you can either do the first version where you take the knees to the floor, or if you prefer, step the left foot forward into runner. When you're ready to, raise the right knee up, step the right foot forward. Bend the knees deeply on your inhale, you round through the spine, and you bring yourself up to a standing plane. So what we're going to do is we're going to link those poses together. So you're probably saying to yourself, well, there's not 12 poses there, and you're absolutely right. It's because the ones we've just demoed are repeated in the sequence to make up the 12 postures. So please have a sip of water if you'd like to have a sip. And so the first round, we'll do it without the breath. So there's no breath, we're just doing it purely physically. So you come to the top of your mat, and you check that your feet are hip width apart, the heel of one foot is placed into the instep. You come up onto the ball of the foot, you pivot on the ball and you align the toes, and you bring your hands into prayer. Thumbs lightly press into the breastbone, and you check that your head is on top of the spine and the shoulders are relaxed. And you begin to make the connection to the breath. And then when you're ready to, you allow the hands to ascend. So as they ascend, they brush the third eye, and you make your way into the second position and you open up. And then when you're ready to, you come down into a forward fold, the third position. Knees are soft. We always begin with the right side of the body because that's the sun side. You step the right leg back and you make your way into runner pose. And then from here we're going to go down facing dog. So you make your way into down facing dog. So the fifth position is you make your way into rainbow cat, knees to the floor, hug the belly in, tuck the chin under. Then on the inhale, sixth position is extended cat. And we're going back to down dog, number 7. And then we need to step the right foot forward. So you can either bring the knees to the floor and step the right foot forward that way, or from down dog, step the right foot forward. Back to runner, which is position 8. And then we raise the left knee up and we step forward with the left leg. This is position 10. Then with the knees soft, we push the arms forward and up into 11. And then we bring the palms together, descending, brush the third eye, and we come to position 12. So when we step the right leg back and then we step the right leg forward, that's known as half around. So we've practiced half around of Surya Namaskar. When we do the left side, that will make a complete round. So traditionally, we can practice Surya Namaskar for 108 rounds. It takes between an hour to 90 minutes to do. But what we're trying to do is by the end of the week, by Friday, is we're hoping to do about 12 rounds. Maybe more, maybe less. We'll see how we progress. So what we're going to do now is we're going to do the left side, and again, we're not using the breath. So when you're ready, you come into position 1, Pranayama. You raise the arms up, you open up. Position 2. Then a forward fold with the knees soft for 3. And then the left leg steps back, knee to the floor. You look up for 4. Into down facing dog, 5. Then hug the belly in, drop the knees, chin tucks under. Rainbow cat, number 6. Into extended cat for 7. Back to dog for 8. And then we step the left foot forward for runner, which is 9. Then we step the right foot forward, forward bend, 10. Then the knees reach the arms forward and up, open up for 11. Bring the palms together, brush the third eye, land at the heart for 12. Then pause here, breathing deeply in and breathing deeply out. So now we're going to do the following rounds to the rhythm of our breath. Breathing deeply in and breathing deeply out. On the exhale, feel your awareness traveling down through the soles of your feet into the depths of the earth. And then on the inhale, as the breath flows up through your body, feel as if you're creating space through your muscles, your bones, and your joints. Exhaling back down into the depths of the earth. And you become aware of the hands, and on the inhale, as the hands ascend, they brush the third eye. Open up. Exhaling forward, in forward to the earth. And on the inhale, step the right leg back, knee to the floor, look up at the rising sun. On the exhale, step the left leg back to down facing dog. Find the shape. Breathe normally. Take a breath in. As you breathe out, get rid of all the air. When you reach the bottom of the breath, hold the breath out. And as you hold the breath out, you make your way into rainbow cat. Then on the inhale, you make your way into extended cat. Then on the exhale, back to down dog. And you become aware of the right leg. On the inhale, you step the right leg through to runner, looking up, lengthen through the spine. And on the exhale, you step the left leg back, forward, to standing forward bend. On the inhale, bend the knees, reach the arms forward and up, come up, open up. Then bring the palms together, exhaling, brushing the third eye, come and land at the heart. Continue to be aware of the breath and allow the breath to settle. We've done 1.5 rounds now. And then when you next breathe in, the hands ascend, brushing the third eye, you open up. And on the exhale, you forward fold. Left leg on the inhale, step the left leg back, knee to the floor, lengthen through the spine, look up. And then on the exhale, you step back to down facing dog. Find the shape. Breathe normally. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, get rid of all the air. Hold the breath out. And as you hold the breath out, you make your way into rainbow cat.
Then on the inhale,
you come to extended cat. On the exhale, you come back to down facing dog. On the inhale, it's right leg forward, knees to the floor, right foot forward to runner. Then on the exhale, standing forward bend. Inhale, reach the arms forward, up to the sky, open up, palms together, exhaling, brushing the third eye, come to the heart. Breathing in, the hands ascend, brush the third eye, open up. Breathing out, forward fold. On the inhale, step the left leg back, knee to the floor, look up. On the exhale, make your way to down facing dog. Find the shape. Breathe normally. Take a deep breath in. And as you breathe out, get rid of all the air. Hold the breath out. And as you hold the breath out, make your way into rainbow cat on external breath retention. On the inhale, make your way to extended cat. Then on the exhale, you make your way back to down facing dog. Then the left leg. Inhale, step the left leg through or bring the knees to the floor. And step the left leg forward that way, look up. On the exhale, step the right leg forward. On the inhale, reach the arms forward and up, come up. And then as you breathe out, palms together, brush the third eye, ground at the heart. And continue to be fully present to how your practice is affecting you. Be aware of your breath. Allowing the breath to gently settle. And now behind your closed eyelids, begin to visualize, imagine a beautiful mountain range. And you're standing here on top of the mountain, gazing out to the horizon. And you're waiting with anticipation and excitement for the rising sun. The air is still and you can feel the salt upon your skin and you can taste the salt upon your lips. And below you there is a bay and you know the water is calm like a mirror because the stars are reflected perfectly in the sea and you almost feel as if you're standing in a glitter ball. Feel the grass beneath your feet. Begin to smell the mountain herbs and the spring flowers. Connect with the hush across the earth. And as you stand here awaiting the rising sun, you begin to make a connection with all of our ancestors. So what we know for sure is that our ancestors did practice a form of sun worship. What that form took, we're not entirely sure. Surya Namaskar is first seen in Tantra Yoga about 1,000 years ago, but the images do not reflect the practice that we're doing today. This practice that we see today comes from medieval times. So we begin to connect with all of our ancestors that worshipped the sun, that amazing ball of energy, fire within the sky that enables earth to grow upon the planet. If the sun was a little bit closer, the earth would be too hot for us. And if the sun was slightly further away, the earth would be too cold for life. So the way the sun and the earth are placed within our galaxy is really quite extraordinary. So we begin to connect with that feeling of humility, that feeling of expansion and a feeling of being very humble as we practice Surya Namaskar. And as we rest here on our mountainous landscape, the first ray of sunshine begins to flow across the sea and touches you upon the mountain. The first ray of sun, the sweetest ray of sun. And as the light begins to brighten, you're able to see your landscape that you reside within a little bit more clearly. Exhale your breath down to your feet. Feel the connection you make with the mountain. Feel the root of the mountain. Then on the inhale, allow the hands to ascend. Open up to the sky. See the stars fading. The indigo sky begins to fade and slowly begins brighter as the sun rises. Then exhale, fold into the earth, a gesture of letting go, humility, a gesture of being grateful, a gesture of not understanding everything. Then when you're ready, on the inhale, you step the right leg back and you place the right knee onto the floor. And if you've ever practiced Surya Namaskar early in the morning with the rising sun, you will find that the sun is always here at the third eye, at Brahmadya. So it's really interesting when you practice it in nature, how you always have it activating the third eye. Our ancestors must have known this if they did this form of worship. Then when you're ready to, when you next breathe out, you make your way into down facing dog. Hold the shape. Take a breath in. As you breathe out, get rid of all the air. You reach the bottom of the breath. External retention. Hold the breath out. Make your way into rainbow cap. Then on the inhale, you come into extended cap. When you're ready to breathe out, you go back to down facing dog. Now the right leg, you need to step it through. Either take the knees to the floor or step it through from dog. On the inhale, step the right leg forward, back to runner, looking up to the sun. Then on the exhale, step the left leg through. Then you bend the knees, and as you breathe in, you reach the arms forward and up to the sky, opening up. See that the sky has become a light lilac color and the stars have vanished. Palms together, exhaling, brush the third eye, ground at the heart. Continuing to look at your mountainous landscape, and as the sun becomes higher and the earth begins to warm, you can smell the flowers and the herbs a little bit more intensely, and you're able to see all the animals that inhabit the sea, the whales and the dolphins and the sharks. You can hear their call, you can hear the call of the seabirds. Exhaling, ground your awareness through the contact your feet make with the mountain. Then as you breathe in, ascending, opening up. Exhale to forward fold. Inhale the left leg back, runner, look up. Exhale to down facing dog. Find the shape. Take a deep breath in. And as you breathe out, get rid of all the air till you reach the bottom of the breath. Hold the breath out. And make your way into rainbow cap. Then on the inhale, you come to extended cap. On the exhale, you go back to down facing dog. Then you become aware of the left leg. Either step the left leg through or place the knees on the floor. Inhale, bring in the left leg forward, back to runner. Then exhaling, standing forward bend. Inhale, bend the knees, push the arms forward and up, you come up. Then the palms touch. Exhale, brush the third eye, come to land at the heart. Pause here between rounds. Allow the breath to settle. So what we're going to do now is we're going to speed up the practice just a little bit so we can have the breath flowing more in rhythm to the movements that we're making. So you continue to visualize the beautiful landscape that you're practicing in, feeling the sea breeze upon your skin, observing how the sun has risen a little bit higher, and notice how the landscape is. See the curves and undulations of the bay and the mountain. Watch the animals that live and inhabit this bay. And see the sapphire, clear blue sea beyond and below you. Then as you breathe out, you ground your awareness with the connection your feet make to the earth. Then on the inhale, the hands ascend and you open up. Exhaling to a forward fold. Right leg, breathe in to runner, look up. Exhale to down facing dog. Hold the breath out at the bottom of the breath. Hold the breath out, rainbow cat. Inhale, extended cat. Exhale to down facing dog. Right foot forward, either knees to the floor or step it through. Inhale the right foot forward. Exhale to standing forward bend. Inhale, bend the knees, reach the arms forward and up, open up. Palms together, exhale, brush the third eye, land at the heart. Breathing in, ascending, brushing the third eye, opening up. Breathing out, forward fold. Inhale, the left leg back, knee to the floor, right knee overshoots the ankle. Exhale to down facing dog. Hold the breath out, rainbow cat. Inhale, extended cat. Exhale, back to down facing dog. Inhale, the left foot forward to runner. Looking up. Exhale, the right foot forward. Bend the knees, breathing in, reach the arms forward and up above the head. Palms touch, exhale, brush the third eye and come to land at the heart. And allowing the breath to settle between rounds, and notice how the sun has now traveled to the west. The sun is beginning to set and you turn your back to the sea as you watch the setting sun. You watch the sky as it changes colours, a beautiful, magnificent sunset. The first stars begin to appear, but the sun is still there. You can still see it slightly on the horizon. And the first quarter of a moon begins to appear, just a tiny, thin sliver of a moon. And then you're ready to salute the setting sun. On the inhale, your hands brush the third eye. You come up, you open. Exhale, fold forward, let go. Have gratitude in your heart, a gesture of releasing. On the inhale, step the right leg back, come to runner. Exhale to down facing dog. Hold the breath out. As you hold out, rainbow cat. Inhale, extended cat. Exhale to dog. Inhale, the right foot forward to runner. Exhale, standing forward bend. Inhale, bend the knees, push the arms forward and up, open up. Exhale, palms together, brush the third eye, land at the heart. Breathing in, up we come, open up to the night sky and the moon. Exhaling, forward fold. Inhale, the left leg back runner. Exhale to down facing dog. Hold the breath out, rainbow cat. Inhale, extended cat. Exhale, down facing dog. Inhale, the left foot forward to runner. Exhale, standing forward bend. Inhale, bend the knees, push the arms forward and up. Open up, palms together. Exhaling, brushing the third eye, grounding at the heart. So having saluted the sun, we're still visualizing that we're on top of the mountain. Deep indigo, starry night, and the first part phase of the moon. And what we're going to do now is we're going to gently comb or stroke or brush our aura down. So you release the arms to the sides of your body. And then as you breathe in, you circle and you have a sense that you're gathering all the life force. So inhaling, gathering the life force that flows through you and flows through the universe. Exhaling, bringing the life force to the crown. And your hands never touch your body. Exhaling to the back of your neck. Inhaling back to the crown. Then exhale down the front of the body to the navel. Breathing in, take the arms round your back. Exhale, travel down the backs of the legs. Backs of the hands unite. Visualize a fountain of color and light. And then as you breathe in, you breathe in, you bend the knees and you draw your hands up the midline, all the way up, and you open up to the universe. Then on the exhale, gathering the life force, bringing the prana, the chi, down to the crown, to the back of the head. Inhaling it, bringing it back to the crown, and exhaling down the front, down to the navel. On the inhale, you take the hands behind you, and on the exhale, you allow the hands to travel down the backs of the legs. Backs of the hands unite between your feet. Bend the knees, breathing in. Draw that energy, that fountain of light and color up, opening up to the starry night. Exhaling, drawing the prana into the crown of your head, to the back of your neck. Breathing in back to the crown and breathe out down to the navel. Inhaling, take the hands behind you. Exhaling, the hands travel down the backs of the legs. Allow the backs of the hands to unite. Breathing in, bend the knees, rounding through the spine, drawing the hands up, the hands brush the third eye, open up. And this time as you breathe out, draw the hands together above the head, bring the hands to the crown, salute the crown, bring the hands to the eyebrow center, salute the eyebrow center, bring the hands to the throat, a salutation to the throat, rest your hands here at the heart, salutation to the heart. Pause. Release the arms, and as you breathe out, forward folding with the knees bent, you come down. Widen your stance a little bit, come onto your toes and make your way into a squat with your arms between your legs. So your knees and your feet, if you're squatting on a clock, are at 10 to 2. Place your hands onto the floor, open your fingers and thumb, and then just take your weight forward. So we open up that pelvic basin and we release the lower back a little. Breathing freely and normally. And then when you're ready to, you're making your way to lie down upon your back in semi-supine, please. So you're lying in semi-supine and you're allowing the energy of the practice to settle into the depths of your atoms, molecules and cells. And you're just allowing yourself to breathe easily and freely. And as you're breathing easily and freely, maybe you can feel on the inhale that the belly slightly expands. And on the exhale that the belly softens. It's ever so soft. And this belly area links us very much to the sun. It's the solar plex area. And the umbilical that linked us with our mums. Our mum used to be the giver of life to us until the umbilical cord got severed. And then the sun is the vivifier, of all life. So again, we can make that connection of life with the sun as we make the connection with being born into the world and conceived within our mother's belly. And this area of the belly is all about how we digest and process emotions and also how we digest and process food. So it's a real powerful emotive area to be working. So to work into this area a little bit more, you're going to bring your knees to your belly and you place your hands to your knees. On the inhale, you take the knees away from the belly, but your hands stay on the knees, and what limits how far the knees go away are the length of your arms. And as you breathe out, you hug the knees in towards the belly. Breathing in, you take the knees away. And breathing out, you hug them in close. Inhale the knees away. And breathing out, you hug them in close. And you continue in this way. And if you've got a big belly like I have and beautiful chunky thighs, you might find that the thighs and the belly connect really easily. If you have a body shape that's beautiful and different to mine, you might find that you're having a different experience. But what we're doing is we're massaging the internal organs. And we're beginning to activate this center a little bit more. We're also massaging the lower back. So if you have no issues with your neck, on the exhale, you can raise the head up to the knees. And on the inhale, you can place the head back down and take the knees away. Breathing out, coming up, head to knees, knees to head. Inhaling, coming down. Exhaling, curling up. And then inhaling, coming down. You continue this way. And then keep hold of the knees, keep your head on the floor here. And we're going to do something a little bit different. So just listen and maybe turn your head to the camera, or if you need to sit up, sit up. So what's going to happen now is, watch me, I'm going to take a breath in. And then as I breathe out, I bring my belly to my thighs, and that helps me to get rid of the air within the trunk of my body. As I hold the breath out, it's external retention, I raise the head up. And then I release on the inhale. So I'll do it without talking. There's no strain, and you want to manage your breath capacity so that when you exhale and then you raise the head up on the external retention, well, you're taking the inhale so that you've got enough capacity that you don't have to have a rest between rounds. You can go into the next round and you don't feel out of breath. However, if you're finding that you're not getting the capacity right and you need to take a few extra breaths between rounds, then please make sure you do so. So when you're ready to, we'll do that together. Take a deep breath in. And as you breathe out, draw the knees to the belly. Get rid of all the air. Hold the breath out. As you hold the breath out, raise the head up. And then when you're ready to breathe in, release. Let's have a few transitional breaths here, because some of you might be new to this practice. Take a breath in, and as you breathe out, hug the belly in, or draw the knees to the belly, get rid of all the air. Hold the breath out, and as you hold the breath out, raise the head up. And then on your inhale, place your head onto the floor and release. Exhaling, hug the belly in, get rid of all the air, hold the breath out, and then as you hold the breath out, you raise the head up. And then on your inhale, you release the shape. Continue in this way. Do a few rounds on your own, because I know that when I'm guiding you and talking to you, I'm limiting your exploration. I'm also limiting your breath capacity. So when you're ready to do a few rounds on your own, please. One more round. And when you've completed that round, keep your hands on your knees and begin to trace circles. Half a circle on an inhale and half a circle on the exhale. Still working the internal organs and also massaging the lower back. And now circle the opposite way. And then bring the practice to a close and allow yourself to just pause for a moment in semi-supine. Or if you wish to lie with your legs flat to the floor, feel free to lie with your legs flat to the floor. Whichever feels most appropriate for you. And as you lie here, you're just allowing everything to slip and release and let go. When you next breathe out, feel the connection your wondrous body makes to the earth. And you're preparing for your meditation. Following meditation, we're going to go back into a relaxation. So can you please make sure you have all your layers and your props so that you can do that part of the class? Need to have a drink of water, please make sure you do so. You're bringing yourself to a comfortable seated position. So our meditation practice is a very simple one. So samavritti pranayama, equal ratio breathing. It's a really nice one for releasing anxiety and bringing balance and equilibrium into our system. So bringing yourself to a comfortable seated position, cross-legged, kneeling, legs stretched out in front of you, or sat upon a chair. And place your hands in the Gya Mudra, so your thumb and index fingers touch, or your index fingers connect with the base or the roots of the thumbs. The hands rest upon the knees if you're crossed, or in any other seated position upon the thighs. And then just lengthen through the spine, relax through the shoulders, place the head on top of the spine. Allow the chin to tuck down and take it back a little bit. And then remember your thread at the crown of your head towards the back of the head, that thread that's linked to a helium balloon. And feel yourself being gently pulled up towards the celestial plane. And then allow there to be a little gap between your teeth and for your lips to be lightly touching. And you're just breathing normally and freely here, allowing the breath to help you settle into the shape. Behind your closed eyelids, begin to visualize a square of any color of your choice. And we're just using our awareness to travel around the square. So you begin at the bottom left-hand corner. You travel down the bottom side of the square to the bottom right-hand corner. Then you travel up the right-hand side of the square to the top right-hand corner. Then you travel across the top of the square to the top left-hand corner. Then you travel down the left side of the square to the bottom left-hand corner. We'll do that once again. From the left bottom corner, travel across to the bottom right-hand corner. Then travel from the bottom right-hand corner to the top right-hand corner. From here, travel across to the top left-hand corner. From here, travel down to the bottom left-hand corner. Let's do it with the breath. Inhaling from the bottom left-hand corner to the bottom right-hand corner. Hold the breath in, travel up to the top right-hand corner, exhaling to the top left-hand corner, hold the breath out, travel down to the bottom left-hand corner, inhaling left corner to bottom right corner, hold the breath in, travel up to the top right-hand corner, exhaling from the top right corner to the top left corner, hold the breath out, travel down to the bottom left-hand corner. So what we do now is to make sure that the breath is equal and even, is we introduce a count. And the element that's usually placed within the navel center, within Manipura, is the element of fire. And the bija sound, the seed sound for fire, is ram. So we'll count one ram, two rams, then hold the breath. One ram, two rams, then exhaling, one ram, two rams, then hold the breath out, one ram, two rams. Okay, so if we begin at the bottom left-hand corner of the square, inhaling to the right-hand corner, one ram, two rams, Hold the breath in, travel up to the top right hand corner. One ram, two rams. Exhale in from the top right hand corner to the left corner. One ram, two rams. Hold the breath out, travel from the top left hand corner to the bottom left hand corner. One ram, two rams. Inhale into the bottom right hand corner. One ram, two rams. Hold the breath in, travel up to the top right hand corner. One ram, two rams. Exhaling from the top right corner to the top left corner. One ram, two rams. Hold the breath out, travel down to the bottom left hand corner. One ram, two rams. Inhaling from the bottom left corner to the right corner. One ram, two rams. Hold the breath in, travel to the top right hand corner. One ram, two rams. Exhaling to the top left hand corner. One ram, two rams. Hold the breath out to the bottom left hand corner. One ram, two rams. Continuing this way to your own breath capacity. Complete one more round. And then releasing the practice and allow yourself to simply sit. Simply sit in the present moment. Allow yourself to simply explore being present. Present of bodily sensations, the air upon your skin, clothes upon your skin, presence of the movements of the world around you, sounds that you may be able to hear, or stillness or silence. Present to the movements of your mind, your thoughts. There's no right or wrong. Allow yourself to simply be. And one more breath here. When you next breathe out, feel the connection that your sit bones, your shin bones, your feet, the backs of your legs make to the earth. Feel that connection, body to floor, floor to body. Begin to become aware of the room you're in, the shape of the room where your windows and your doors are, whom you are sharing the space with. And then very gently, beginning to transition from seated to lying for your relaxation, please. So you can lie on your back with your legs flat to the floor and your arms by the sides. You can lie in semi-supine with your knees bent and your feet flat to the floor. Or if you prefer, you can lie on your tummy in crocodile pose, supporting your head with your hands. Wrapping yourself up warm, making sure that you're very, very comfortable. Making any adjustments to clothes and covers. And then allowing the process of deep nourishment and restoration to happen during this practice of relaxation. And it's through the process of relaxation, when the body becomes still, that the body is able to use the energy that you've created in your practice to deeply heal and nourish all the layers of your being, physical, mental, emotional, energetic. So I'm going to take you on a journey around your body. You don't need to move. You just use your imagination. And when I refer to that part of the body, see if you can relax it. Inhaling into your feet. And as you exhale, relax your feet. Breathe into your legs. And as you breathe out, soften your legs. Inhaling into your buttocks. And on an out breath, relax your buttocks. Breathe into your back. And as you breathe out, relax your back. Your awareness flows to your belly. Inhaling into your belly. And as you exhale, relax your belly. Breathe into your chest. And on an out breath, relax your chest. Taking your awareness now to your hands and arms. Breathe into your hands. And as you breathe out, relax the backs of your hands, palms of your hands, each finger and thumb. Inhaling into your arms. And on an out breath, relax your arms. Breathe into the tops of your shoulders. And as you breathe out, relax and soften the tops of your shoulders. Inhaling into the whole of your neck. And as you exhale, relax and soften the whole of your neck. Breathe into the whole of your head. And on an out breath, relax your head. Inhaling into your beautiful face. And as you breathe out, relax and soften your forehead, temples, cheeks and jaw lines. Relax your eyebrows, the space between your eyebrows. Soften your eyes, eyelids and lashes. Relax your nose, the tip of your nose. Soften the root of your tongue, the whole of your tongue, teeth, lips and chin. Breathing into the whole of your body. And as you breathe out, relax the whole of your body. Inhaling into the whole of your body. And as you breathe out, deeply relax the whole of your body. The whole of your body begins to soften. In your mind's eye, behind your closed eyelids, begin to imagine, visualize a beautiful mountain range close to the sea. Early in the morning, you're standing on top of the mountain in mountain pose. And you're waiting with anticipation and excitement for the rising sun. Feel the long grasses on the soles of your feet and brushing against your calves. Feel the or smell the sweet sea air and the spring flowers and the herbs. You know that the sea is calm, but you can hear her rolling gently in and out as the night sky is perfectly reflected in her. The stars are shining like diamonds. You cannot tell apart the sky and the horizon, so you feel as if you're in a glitter ball. You can taste the salt upon your lips, and you can feel the salt upon your skin. There's a great hush across the land as everyone waits in anticipation for the rising of the sun, for the dawning of a new day. And as the sun removes the darkness and begins to awaken all life upon the earth, we use that as a metaphor within our practice. As the light, the sun rises within us, the light within us begins to awaken us, helps us to become conscious beings, aware of our thoughts, our actions, and our behaviors, how they impact upon us, how they impact upon others, and how they impact on the wider world. It's a beautiful practice. And then slowly you see the first ray of light traveling across the bay, and you feel that soft, sweet sunshine gently touching your body. You can hear the earth groan as she receives the first light. And on your inhale, you gently raise the arms up, brushing the third eye, and you open up and you see that the sky is beginning to brighten, the stars are gently beginning to fade. And on the exhale, you come into your forward fold. You make the connection with the earth, and you have a sense that you're letting go, releasing anything you need to let go of. On the inhale, you step the right leg back, you place the knee onto the earth, onto the mountain, and you look up to the horizon, and you can see the sun as he gently rises. Exhaling, you make your way into down facing dog. You get rid of all the air and you hold the breath out, and as you hold the breath out, you make your way into rainbow cat. Then on the inhale, you make your way back into extended cat. Then on the exhale, back to down facing dog. When you're ready to breathe in, you step the right foot forward, left knee to the earth, and you're looking up to the rising sun. On the exhale, you come back to your forward fold. Then on the inhale, you bend the knees a little, reach the arms forward and up, and you come up and you open your arms wide to the sky. The sky is a beautiful light sapphire blue, and the sun is still not intense. As the sun is rising, you can feel the sweet scent of the herbs and the flowers beginning to intensify. On the exhale, bring your hands to prayer and land them at the heart. Breathing in, traveling up to the sky, opening up. Exhaling into your forward fold, a feeling of surrendering and releasing into the earth. On the inhale, step the left leg back, knee to the earth, look up to the sky. Exhaling to down facing dog, get rid of all the air, hold the breath out, rainbow cat. Inhaling to extended cat. Exhaling back to down facing dog. Then on the inhale, step the left foot forward, right knee to the earth, lengthen through the spine, look up, sun is even higher now. Then when you next breathe out, you step forward into your forward fold. Bend the knees a little, inhale, reach the arms forward and up, opening up to the sky. As you breathe out, palms together, brush the third eye, land at the heart. Pause here, feel invigorated. Feel the vivifier, the sun warming you and filling you with intense light and vitality. Allow yourself to lie on top of the mountain, surrounded by the grasses and the warm air and the spring flowers and the herbs. And as you rest here, begin to become aware of the sounds of nature. Listen to the hum of the bees. You become so perfectly still and aware. You can even hear the subtle fluttering of butterfly wings. You can hear the call of the whale and the dolphin. And you can see eagles soaring high on the eddies. Feel the strength and the support of the earth beneath you and allow yourself to expand into the sky. Allow yourself to rest here deeply, feeling interconnected and whole. Relax, relax, and let go.
Om Bhurbhuva Swaha Tat Savitu Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Naha Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuva Swaha Tat Tat Savitu Varenyam Margo Devasya Dimahi Diyoyo Naha Prachodayat Om Bhur Bhuvaswaha Tat Savitu Varenyam Margo Devasya Dimahi Viyoyo Naha Prachodayat.
Have one more breath here. And when you next breathe out, feel the connection your wondrous body makes to the earth. Begin to feel the breath within your trunk. On the inhale, feel the trunk expanding. On the exhale, feel the trunk contracting. Feel the light touch of air within your nasal passageways. As you deepen the breath, begin to introduce gentle movements into your feet and into your hands. And allow those movements to gently ripple through your body, moving more expressively, stretching, yawning, rocking, rolling, sighing out, whatever feels really lovely. When you feel the time is right, you may wish to lie onto a side for a moment. Then when you've rested upon a side, bring yourself up into a comfortable seated position of your choice. And once you have seated, begin to guide your awareness into the heart space, into Hridaya Akash. And this space is located between the chest and the upper back and between the armpits. We're not talking about the physical heart, we're exploring the energetic heart. Here in the heart space, you may wish to visualize a flower of your choosing. And on the inhale, you feel that flower blossoming, opening, spiraling outward. And on the exhale, see that flower spiraling inward. Breathing in, the spiraling flower opens, and breathing out, the spiraling flower closes. And within the flower, begin to visualize the sun resting here. Think of the symbiotic connection the flower has to the sun has to the flower. And here, resting amongst the silky soft petals of the flower, make your dedication. Where do you wish to dedicate your practice to? Place the individual, the place, the plant, the animal here within the flower, being bathed in the intense light of the sun. And we'll chant three Oms so that the vibration of Om carries your deep healing to wherever, whomever, whatever, wherever it needs to go. Breathing in deeply now. drawing the palms together, warming the palms. Placing the warm palms over the closed eyes. Open the eyes behind the palms. Pause here for a moment. And then gently bringing our awareness back into the space. Namaste. Thank you very much for joining us today. If you would like to connect with the four classes that follow this one, then please do get in touch in the details given below. We wish you health and well-being, and may you stay safe during this period. And if we can help you in any way, please do get in touch. Namaste and blessings to all. Thank you. Mm-hmm.